All right, I want to talk about metric prefixes in this video. The first thing I want to point out is that there are a bazillion tables of metric prefixes that you can find on the internet. As you sort of thumb through some of these, you'll see very similar looking tables of metric prefixes. We see one there. Wikipedia has a table of metric prefixes. You can find a lot of examples, and they're not all identical. There are lots of metric prefixes, and a lot of tables will not list all of them, but list several of them, many of them, some of them. And so you'll see them in a variety of ways. I'm going to pull up the metric prefix that we have in our textbook. So this is the metric prefix table from our textbook. I want to point out how it works. All metric prefixes tables are arranged in a very similar fashion. Again, not all of them have exactly the same metric prefixes on it. Some of them will leave some out, and your textbook leaves some out. And so we don't see all of the metric prefixes here. We see giga, which is symbolized with a capital G. The difference between capitals and lowercases matters. Mega, symbolized with a capital M. Kilo with a lowercase k. Hecto, deca, deci, centi, milli, micro, nano, and so on. The similar arrangement that we see no matter what table we look at is that the prefixes that stand for the larger numbers are on top, and the prefixes that stand for the smaller numbers are on bottom. We'll often list a multiplier. Sometimes it'll be called something slightly different, but this is the factor of 10 that this prefix stands for. It'll be given both in a regular number in our textbook and in scientific notation. Now, 10 to the ninth is not quite scientific notation based on what we talked about before. 10 to the ninth is actually 1 times 10 to the ninth if we write it in proper scientific notation. I have 1 and then a decimal place, but I don't have to write it, times 10 to the ninth. 10 to the sixth is 1 times 10 to the sixth, and so on. As I come down here to the negative exponents, this is 1 times 10 to the minus 1. Down here, my micro prefix is 1 times 10 to the minus 6th. This 10 to the minus 6th is not wrong, but you might think of it as 1 times 10 to the minus 6 in order to work your problems better. And we'll talk more about the problems in another video. What these multipliers stand for is they stand for the number of the base unit that goes with one of the prefix. Let me say that again. What the multiplier stands for is the number of the base unit that goes with one of my prefix. Now my base units are my units without the prefix. My base unit can be a meter, it can be a liter, it can be a gram, it can be anything without a prefix. It's a measurement unit without a prefix. When I add the prefix to it, then I have these multipliers which have to be taken into account. So for example, giga, let's take giga for example. Giga means there are 10 to the ninth of the base unit in one of the prefix. If my measuring unit is meters, there are 10 to the ninth meters, the abbreviation for meter is a lowercase m, that are equal to 1 gigameter. Capital G for the prefix, little m for meter. That's how I interpret this table. If I look at a centi, and again, if my base unit is the meter, the multiplier is 10 to the minus 2. That means there are 10 to the minus 2 meters that are equal to 1 centimeter. This works for grams, this works for liters, this works for any of my base units. The way the prefix table works is that the multiplier is the number of the base unit that equals 1 of the prefix. The prefix nano is 10 to the minus 9th. That means there are 10 to the minus 9th meters that equal 1 nanometer. Alright, so that is how every prefix table works. Again, some of the prefix tables will have more prefixes, some of them will have fewer prefixes, just because they've decided to leave some of them out.